Welcome to Naresha Technologies. This is Srinivas. In the last video, I have given the introduction to numerical Python. So in this video, so I'm going to explain how to construct one dimensional array from the list, two dimensional array from the list, and how to display the elements of one dimensional array and two dimensional array. Here, so first directly we are writing the code. So we are importing the module, just NumPy. So while importing that module, so we can give alias names also. For example, NumPy we are importing as an NP. So wherever you want to call NumPy module, simply you can use NP, a short form alias name, simply to say. So here, so first we are taking one list. Just here it is, my list we are taking, and same 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Is a single dimensional array. And how to construct? In the last video already we have seen. Once again, here it is np dot, the function, the name is constructing array by calling that array. We are passing that list as an input, so then it will return that array object that we are collecting. Of course directly we can display, but now I just want to display using loops. Here print elements, for loop, I am repeating for loop. Here it is a simply, without using that range function and index value, from the array it will collect element by element directly, so we can process easily in this way. So from this array it will collect element by element. It will collect element by element, and we are printing that element. Again, it will collect that element. It is printing that element. All elements we can process using the for loop. Using for loop. So here, whenever we are executing just Python program name, the source file name, I have given that practice.py. When I execute that, it is showing all the elements 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So for example, how to construct a two dimensional array. For that, for example, I am taking that list. It's a nested list I am taking. Nested list. List inside the list. Suppose the first element is 10, 20, 30, comma. Second element is 40, 50, 60. Third element is 70, 80, 90. Like this, we are taking the list. Nested list we are taking. So whenever we are passing this list, it will return the array. The generally two-dimensional arrays, we can call it as a matrix. So simply we are giving that name is a matrix. Suppose, if I want to display the elements, in different ways we can display. First of all at once I am displaying, all at once, just print that matrix. You can display like this matrix, we can display all the elements will be displayed automatically. See, it will show in the form of two dimensional array, in the form of two dimensional, just rows and columns it is showing. Sir, I just want to access element by element. Element by element I want to access. So from the matrix, first row, second row, third row, that we are collecting using for loop, the row wise in the matrix, it will collect that first row, nothing but first element, second element, third element. We are printing that row, we are printing that row. So whenever we execute this, execute. Now look at this, it will show like this. Here it is removing this list part, only that first row, second row and third row, nothing but first element, second element and third element of the nested list it is specifying. Sir, element by element I want to process. In each row, element by element I want to process means one more loop, like a nested loop we have to use. Here from the first row, it will collect the first row. From the first row, each element I want to display. Here, one more for loop. each element in the row. Each element in the row. Here we are printing that element. When one row is completed, then outer loop is repeating that second row. Inner loop is printing the each element of that row. So here print function send the control to next line automatically. So whenever we execute, it will show the output like this: 10, 20, 30, 40 and up to 90. No sir, I want to display in a matrix form only. Means after printing that every element, just here it is, we are giving the tab space or simply space. We know that using the argument end with the value space. Once for loop execution completed, it will send the control to next line. Right? It is printing all the elements of a row in a single line. Once the row execution completed, it will send the control to next line. This is how we are printing. So whenever we are executing this one, whenever we are executing, now look at this. It will show exactly in the form of matrix only, like a two-dimensional array only. So this is how we are creating one-dimensional and two-dimensional arrays from the list and how to process the elements using loops. Hope you understood. For more videos, please subscribe to Naresh IT channel. Thank you.